all the good you can, to all the people you can, in all the ways you can, as long as you can.
Virtually from its beginning, the Moody Bible Institute has been involved in the publication and distribution of Christian literature. As was the case with education, the Institute's involvement with publishing can be traced to Mr. Moody. Mr. Moody first expressed interest in publishing during the Civil War when he observed the lack of Christian literature available for the troops. Later as an evangelist, Moody was energized by the lack of inexpensive literature available to new converts. Driven by this need, Moody formulated a bold plan and formed the Bible Institute Cole Portage Association in 1894. The key was producing the literature as inexpensively as possible for the widest distribution. Moody identified four goals.
First, we must stem the awful tide of impure reading matter. Second, we must reach the non-churchgoer. Third, get the printed page into the hands of every criminal behind bars. Fourth, give an opportunity to godly men and women to do more effective service for the master.
In 1941, the Bible Institute Cole Portage Association became known as Moody Press. By this point, it had published almost 34 million copies of sermons, Bible teaching, and doctrinal books, as well as New Testaments. Additionally, over 43 million gospel tracts had been distributed. The boldness of this ministry is illustrated by its work with public schools from 1921 until 1981. Initially spurred by the lack of books in rural schools in Appalachia, Moody Press distributed Bibles and free books to public schools in the region. Each set contained 15 books, including a Bible. In addition, each student was given a Gospel of John. Eventually, the program expanded throughout the United States, so that by its end in 1981, over 7.5 million books were distributed. In addition to books and pamphlets, Moody Bible Institute has sought to do all the good it can to all the people it can through other media. Beginning in 1900, Moody Magazine provided inspiration and biblical instruction until its closure in 2003. The Institute also used film, most notably through the Moody Institute of Science. The films were an outgrowth of the ministry of Dr. Irwin A. Moon. The series proved wildly popular and shaped how an entire generation viewed science and faith. In 1992, Moody Press unveiled another bold initiative, Northfield Publishing, to address non-Christians exploring the Christian faith and to present biblical principles for living to a general audience. In 2004, Moody Press changed its name to Moody Publishers. As we look to the 21st century, we have fashioned a dynamic vision to further our mission of helping readers know, love, and serve Jesus Christ. First, Moody Publishers will become more audience-centered rather than project-centered, finding writers for its readers, not readers for its writers. Second, Moody Publishers will use technology more skillfully, providing content in new formats and utilizing print-on-demand technology. Third, Moody Publishers will develop new and stronger connections with Moody Radio and education. Finally, Moody Publishers will utilize the rich cultural diversity of Chicago to pioneer self-sustaining publishing teams that reach people groups across the globe, serving every continent by 2020.
Do all the good you can, to all the people you can, in all the ways you can, as long as you can.
The Moody Bible Institute celebrates the bold legacy of our founder and the dynamic future of serving Christ together in the years to come.